Okay, welcome to the presentation. Today we're going to be covering NinjaTrader 8. I'm from DayTradeToWin, and this is a presentation that will show you how to download NinjaTrader, how to install it, how to use the charts, how to use the dome, all the important features you'd want to know, whether you're coming from NinjaTrader 7 or if you're brand new to NinjaTrader. So this is the first time we are seeing the option to connect a data feed. Now, what is a data feed? A data feed is what connects you to the markets. It's what lets you get live data on your charts. It's very important that you practice with live data. Other than that, you're just going to probably use the random data feed, the simulator, and that's not very good. We want you to practice with the data that's as close as you can get to real market conditions. So here at DayTradeToWin, we can help you get set up with that. Simply email us at support@daytradetowin.com and we'll give you a data feed. By the way, this is what a data feed looks like. It's simply a username and a password. We're going to be plugging this in here shortly. And again, our email is support@daytradetowin.com. I'm just pausing here. Is everyone doing okay in the room? And if you have any questions so far, just let me know. This will ask us for the data feed. I could simply copy and paste the data feed that's right here into the username and password box, but because this is the first time we're setting up Ninja, I'm going to skip this step. I prefer to set up data feeds manually. And the reason for that is when you set up a data feed using that screen, NinjaTrader might set it up so that it automatically connects to that data feed upon startup. And if you ever have a problem where that data feed is expired, when you go to log in, NinjaTrader might be slow to start and might hang. This way, when you set it up manually, you can choose not to have it start automatically connect, and it will give you more freedom. Okay, so this is the getting started window. We don't need to use this. You've got this presentation to watch today, and we're going to go through some of the basics, so we can ignore this. I recommend clicking Do Not Show again, and then clicking on Close. Okay, so this is the NinjaTrader Control Center. This is the main screen that you're going to use all the time to open new charts with, adjust your markets, your instruments, open workspaces, connect to data feeds, receive help, activate indicators, and so on. The first thing I recommend doing if you're setting up NinjaTrader is getting that data feed plugged in, because you really can't do a whole lot without a live data feed in terms of meaningful practice. So to do that, go to Connections and then go to Configure. You can see that there are a bunch of different providers here, but for this type of data feed, the one that we can assist you with, we're going to use the NinjaTrader Continuum connection, which is right here. So we're going to click on Add. You can see how the area here on the right becomes accessible. The default name is my NinjaTrader Continuum. That's fine. Here's that connect on startup option. Leave that unchecked. We don't want that. The username we're going to use is right here. So I'm copying it and pasting it. In case you're new to Windows or you simply don't know, a way to copy is to use the control key and then hit C. So you're going to hold down control and hit C once you have text highlighted. And that will give you the text on the clipboard, which you can then paste here via Control plus V. So this is copy, and this is paste. This will work through all different programs in Windows, word processors, web browsers, whatever you want. So we've got the username, and now let's get the password in place. So this particular data feed, by the way, will expire in 2 weeks' time. So if I get a message that says unspecified login error or something like that when I go to connect, I know that's probably time to renew a data feed or maybe open a live account, depending on my situation. One thing you want to make sure that you have checked is this demo box. This is a demo data feed. When you have an account with a broker, they'll give you a different set of connection information. Just to answer a question here from Jeff, yes, there will be a recording of this training and it will be on the blog. The data feed is pretty much set up at this point. All we need to do is click on OK. This is a normal message that appears. It's just giving you sort of like a disclaimer about order cancel, orders that might come up. So just click on OK to that, no big deal. Now to connect to that data feed, you'll go to connections and then click on the name of the data feed. If you recall, it's My NinjaTrader Continuum. So click on that. Now look in the bottom left corner of this control center. It's now yellow because it's trying to connect to the data feed. Once it connects, it should turn green. You may have heard that sound as well, indicating that we're connected. So now we should be able to open up a chart and get live data. So if you're comparing NinjaTrader 8 to 7, you'll notice that there are a few menu changes. You'll just get used to where everything is. We're going to go over some basic things next, like opening up a chart, opening up a dome. But it's important every time you open up NinjaTrader to connect to that data feed first. So every time you open up connections, click on the data feed that you set up. If you ever need to change your settings in the data feed, perhaps you have a new data feed that you want to apply, you would go to configure, select the data feed that you have set up down here. You can see it's under the configured heading. You don't need to use this. And then change out the username and the password to the new demo data feed that you have. Thank you everyone for attending. And if you have any more questions, let us know.